Hello! Here we are. It's Astra season. You know, I used to really loathe Astra season. Like, I used to, not look forward to it. There's a term for that. Hold on. Dread! That's the word I'm looking for. I used to dread the approach of Astra season. But you know, I'm actually pretty excited this Astra season because I put some interesting teams together for once. So, it's funny how the game flip-flops like that, right? Although, now I don't really mind either season. I used to dread light season, honestly. So, the way it goes is, Astra has, I feel for a lot of people, Astra season has been like my, and I feel like a lot of players' weakest team. But ever since I got Summer Edelgard and I've been doing hit and run Gale Force with her, Astra season was my strongest teams. It was so easy, right? And then, like, I dreaded light season all the time because, like, I think around that time, Yune had her remix refine, whatever, and Omni tanks weren't super prevalent yet. Maybe they were, but I just wasn't into it yet. But, I mean, honestly, Yune's not a problem so long as you have a bunch of Unity skills to pass out. But at the time, like, I think it was a time where I was still trying to figure out Aetherize. Like, I only recently, and when I say recently, I mean like the last year or so, I've only really been taking Aetherize seriously for the last year or so, right? So, anyways, light season was tricky for me after I strengthened my Astra teams with Edelgard. But now, Edelgard's kind of fallen off. Gale forcing with her is iffy. Hit and run is still decent with her, admittedly. But, yeah. And then it got to a point where, like, Edelgard, I felt like Edelgard was falling off, for my playstyle anyway. And I got Duo Asker and some Unity fodder piled up. And then I was like, light season is kind of where it's at for me right now, because I had Duo Asker, he could kind of deal with anything, and I think not a lot of people had really gotten into Yune yet, or maybe Yune got a remix refine around when Duo Asker came out. I don't quite remember the timeline there, but Duo Asker is where I really started shining in light season, because I mean he can do everything and anything, but I didn't have Spiral 4 on him yet, and that was where Yune became a big problem. And like, light season was like the one I started looking forward to for not that long, because Yune kind of ruined my life for a bit there. But again, now that I got Spiral 4 on my Asker, it's still peaches and cream. It's fine. But also, if you've given yourself over to the hype of Omni tanking, light season is kind of a breeze. Especially when you have the tools like Legend Robin, and you can use like Young Ellawood. You don't have to, it doesn't matter if it's not wind season anymore, you can still do the bubble double stuff crap. Robin has to be earth season, but like, anyways, that's just what I'm getting at. Like, if you've got, like, there's so many like diverse powerful Omni tanks that like light season isn't that bad anymore, and that's kind of, you're forced to Omni tank because of the existence of Embla. I mean, not everyone has Embla on their defenses, but anyways, so that's kind of what I'm getting at. But this is like the first time in a little while where Astra, I'm kind of excited for it again. Now, when Legend Yuri came out, that Astra season was really fun because I could just play around with him and it wasn't that bad. Although I did still have some like matches that I struggled with, but you know, there'll always be tough matches like that. But anyways, I've got some interesting teams cooked up here. Now, there were some teams where I wanted to use both Legend Robin and Legend Ellawood because it is Wind Earth season right now. It is prime to use Omni tanking in Astra season. But I couldn't slot in a dragon or beast for Ellawood to work in every team, so I would say 4 out of 5 teams just has Robin, or like my first team here doesn't even have either one. It's just my hit and run Edelgard with Yuri to kind of help out. This is just a classic hit and run AoE Yuri into Edelgard. It tried and true, works pretty decent. Yeah, but, you know, thankfully it is wind season, and we can use better Yuri instead of original Yuri. So that's nice. If I had to use original Yuri, it'd be a little trickier because I don't run an AoE on him. I use lethality. Although I probably could use AoE, I suppose. Anyways, that doesn't matter. So that's that. We got Regan as the bonus unit on every team, pretty much, because I'm too lazy and I don't want to try anything with Felix. I just don't feel like it. So I just have like a Regan. She's not really doing anything here, to be honest. You know. So normal stuff there, as it always have been. Now, I'm actually excited about this Dimitri team. I don't use Brave Dimitri much. He actually used to be on my light teams. But I realized, when am I ever going to use Brave Dimitri over Duo Asker? When I got to a point where I was looking at the map and I was thinking about using Brave Dimitri, I would then be like, yeah, but Asker though. You know what I mean? Like, so eventually I made the decision to swap Dimitri over to Astra because, one, the main reason is one of my anima defenses one of the weeks got absolutely demolished by a Brave Dimitri, which is commonplace whether it's Light or Astra, but, I mean, I just figured I don't have any Omni tanks on Astra at all, so I figured I may as well just put Dimitri over here. And, fortunately, there's a lot of units that can buff his speed. There's Plumeria and Illmind to give him +8 speed. Then Regan, the bonus unit, coupled with Seether, are just giving him +6 attack. And all of them together is giving him +20 HP. That's pretty sweet. And then, again, since it's Earth season, we can double dip into the Unity. Just heal up with Noontime, Special Spiral 4, True Damage, and it's fun times for everybody. I hope. We'll see how that works out. And then Regan's just here with the double tech, just giving some buffs on top of the Unity stuff. And hopefully it works out good. And actually, I put Fort Dev Res on Seether just because she doesn't really need Sky High attack, and she gets one extra point of Res as opposed to Fury. And I should probably make that change there too, but yeah, whatever. Now, the next team is very similar to the second team in that I'm using Fjorm as the Omni tank instead of Dimitri. I know, it's crazy, but hear me out. So Fjorm's here. Darting Breath is just to ensure she can get Ice Mirror through guard. Like, get Ice Mirror back up through guard. And then everything else, it's just the same. It's just I have 4 mythics to give her +20 HP. She's getting +9 attack from Seether, Regan, and Altenna. Now, it's very important that Altenna's here so that she can fly around with guidance. And Robin, obviously, is just an Omni tank's best friend. So that's what I'm cooking here. And then Elamine is just a staple on all my Astra teams because Elamine is Elamine. If you think Elamine's bad, then you're crazy. And also, she gives 4 speed. That's goated. Elamine is, like, actually the best Astra mythic. And I feel like that's going to withstand the test of time just because of how she functions. It's, like, because of, like, what she can do, like, her... because Elamine has, what's it called? What actually is it called? False Start. So because Elamine is still the only character with False Start, and she gives speed as her mythic bonus, I feel like she's going to withstand the test of time as, like, the best Astra mythic. Anyways, moving on. So that's that team. This team is just Omni Tank Claude. And I have my brother Gillian here to get rid of his weakness to bows and also act as his near saver, because Claude is just to deal with the range threats. My normal Claude as he's been, Deadeye Unity Claude with the seal speed. Thor's here just to make sure he can get off those Deadeyes, because Claude does have tempo and is refined. Well, tempo for himself. Regan is, again, just tactic buffing Claude there. Again, the Omni Tank best friend in the form of Robin. And this team is the preempt Yuri team. It doesn't always work, and it's a challenge to use it, but man, when it works, it's so satisfying. So I just wanted to keep it here and give it another college try. Plus, I mean, he has a flat attack of 76. It's crazy. He's got the triple mythic buffs. He can walk on the magic traps, and he doesn't care because he's got 66 HP. And he's being double buffed because I have Valoria here to activate his AoE, so it's fine. So yeah, those are the teams. I foresee good things, but let's see how it goes. Okay. The first adversary is a Kjell user. First save, Kjell. And what the fuck? Why do you have two Katrias? That is not what you want to see. Oh my goodness. Okay, so this kind of sucks. So, what's their plan? Are they just trying to make sure they have triangle attack no matter what? Okay. Double Katria on Astra is actually the good. Okay, it makes sense because of Elamine. I can only shut off one of their Katrias, and then the other one is going to make sure that the rest of the team gets triangle attack. I get it. I see what you're doing. Bravo. Damn it! okay, so I guess since they're going to have triangle attack active no matter what, I should probably just false start the Sarah? Does that matter? Does that even do anything for me? Spiral 4 Henriette. God damn. So what does your stuff do at the start of turn? Start of turn, if penalty is active on any allies within four spaces of a unit, excluding unit, grants 6 attack speed to ally with the lowest HP among them for one turn and neutralizes penalties. Okay, so yeah, I'll false start the Sarah since, like, I can't false start both Katrias. So. Having a second Elamine really would be, like, decent because she does give that plus 4 speed, but... Eh, whatever. So what am I going to do here? So Kjell makes it hard to use Edelgard, but I feel like Yuri could still punch through her if I needed someone to do that. That's also a near save. Okay, so this Kjell is like definitely here to counter Summer Edelgard's. Yuri can definitely kill this Henriette and then probably damage most other things. The AoE is... It's unfortunate that healing tower is there because it's going to heal him up, but... Maybe what I do is I snipe the healing tower, back off, and then initiate afterwards. Okay, so that counter control is going to activate on Yuri no matter where I initiate from. Actually, the only spot I could initiate from is, like, right here. If I attacked Saros from right here, I wouldn't get Kanto controlled. Is that worth trying to do? Maybe. Maybe it is. Try Dimitri Kun. Sarah... is a little annoying here because I don't want to get triangle attacked by Sarah. She can fly in and then hit this spot. I won't be able to attack her because of the dazzling staff. Is Fjorm the way to go here? Because if I just park Fjorm here, sure, Sarah could warp in and triangle attack me, but I will kill her. And then the only other option the AI would have is to come in and attack with this Katria, and then that's pretty much it. Maybe once they start moving their other allies, something else could pop in, like this Henriette could probably come in and triangle attack me, but Fjorm has guard, so she shouldn't get her iceberg off. This is only one, minus one cooldown, right, at start of turn? Yeah, so she's not going to get cooldown from anywhere else. Fjorm should be able to take that Henriette if she were to pop in. I think I'm just going to try Fjorm. Fjorm can probably do this. Let's go. Freeze. I think Fjorm can do this. I believe in the Fjorm. So, I'm going to false start the Sarah. Ooh, I can lock someone out as well. Actually, she would just fly in anyways, wouldn't she? She could fly in as well as Sarah. Either one of them could attack first. It wouldn't really matter. Then there's also the Mirabilis, which might not matter. I'm not sure. Maybe. I'm just going to probably lock one of the Catrias down just to be safe on that front. Yeah, I guess we'll just see how this goes. Can I also... no, I can't try Altena because of Sarah. So. Honestly, this might be a flop, but let's just see how it goes. So... You have to stay here.
I see a way forward.
You have my trust.
So maybe you go here. No, wait, I want Robin to be where Fjorm is right now. Okay, maybe I do something like this. You do have swap, that's really good. Okay, so maybe I break this. Altena can aerobatics over here. Then Fjorm can fly up there with guidance. Then you could swap into Altena so that you're within two spaces of Fjorm.
Without a doubt.
Oh man, this is a lot right now. I mean, you need to stay here. Well, I can break that, I suppose. Well, actually, Elamai needs to go there. Damn. Okay, so.
Yeah.
I think that's the move. We break this. You can go there. You come here. You come up here. You swap. There. You break that and trace up, and you stay where you are.
The future is in sight.
And we clench and pray. Oh my god. Maybe I should have deflect magic on Fjorm. Oh shit. Okay, not too bad. She's not dead. Oh my god! Okay. No! She's dead. Oh, she's dead. That's so sad. No. Oh, that sucks, man. Oh. She took way too much damage from that Catria. That sucks so much. Alright, well, what are you gonna do? What does Fjorm have as a sacred seal? Let me check that super quick. Alright. Darting Breath. Maybe I should just have, like, her steady stance on instead for the extra defense. I don't know if that'd really do anything for her, though. Defense res unity with Robin would be the best, but I don't have that. Damn, this sucks. I don't think there's really anything I could have done differently there. I mean, I could have just not tried to tank their whole fucking team right off the bat, but... shit. Dude, double Catria is a problem I didn't think I was gonna have to deal with. If she had deflect magic, it actually would have been fine. Alright, you know what? Alright, I kind of don't like giving up Darting Breath, but since that particular style of team is where I will just use Fjorm from now on anyways, I will just have deflect magic on her just to circumvent those issues moving forward. Because she actually would have been fine. That's so unfortunate. But, whatever. It is what it is. Now we need to go again. And now we've got something like this. What the hell? What do you even do? I don't have anybody with hearting bearings, so that's kind of unfortunate. Are you a near save? You're a far save. They have no near save. Again, I don't have hearty bearing on anybody, so this Camilla's really annoying. Well, okay, so what I'm gonna have to do, I think I need to use the Edelgard team on this one, just because I don't know if I can deal with Kronia otherwise. Or maybe Preempt Yuri? Because, like, Preempt Yuri can deal with Sonya, Camilla, Bernadetta, and Kronia. Just go up, kill for Mortis. There is no Kanto control, so just Kanto anywhere is where Formortis can't get to me, like off a dance. So like just Kanto like here, or even like one of these two spots here, that would be fine. Yeah, you know what, this is like all range units, so maybe I just go with the Preempt Yuri. He's fast enough, this Windsweep just does nothing. Is there any kind of panic? Well, actually, it wouldn't matter, but... Okay. Yo, let's go? He does still have Disarm Trap, so yo, let's go? Preempt Yuri? Actually, maybe gonna work? Okay. Sorry? Yeah. Well, if I hit from here, he'll die. So... Yup. It doesn't matter who I lock out, really. What does this do? When used HP is less than 99%, enables count to 1, inflicts attack speed -3 on foe during combat. If unit's HP is above, is below 100%, unit can move to a space adjacent to any ally within 3 spaces. If unit's HP is less than 60%, unit can move to a space adjacent to any ally. Within 3 spaces. So that means she could warp, like, here. Holy shit. Oh, no, that's not what that means. No, I'm dumb. It's... Unit can move to a space adjacent to any ally within 3 spaces. Okay, so it's all, like, still up to here. So... She could go here... Basically, she could go here. That's where she can go. She could also go there. She can go, like, warp over here, basically. I guess that's fine. Maybe I'll just have Seether here. Just to lock Kronia out anyway, so I don't have to deal with that. I mean, Yuri would kill her, but... I would rather... Like, Sonya's locking herself out anyways, so... And then you'll just... Dance. Actually, Mirabilis can come and dance anybody. With that Wings of Mercy, I should be a little careful with this warping bowl crap. I do need to have someone within 2 spaces of Yuri to make sure he gets his true damage. So basically, I'm going to go up, and then maybe I'll Kanto here, and have someone here, and then have everybody else just out of the way. Alright, I guess that's the plan? So Formortis dies. This is what we want to see. I didn't even check for a healing tower, actually. I can't believe I didn't even think to look for that. Okay, there's no healing tower, so I don't even really need the true damage. Like, I'll just straight up one-tap all of these things. I mean, none of them have a lot of defense anyways, so it's totally fine. I just don't want any melee attacks. Maybe I should lock out Catria, and then Mira might come and dance Catria, but it doesn't really matter where she goes, right?
I just can't have... Yeah, okay. But, like, I could put you here. And it really just does not matter, does it? Maybe we'll just put you here and lock out Catria. This should be fine. He doesn't have preempt! What the hell am I doing with my life? Hello? Oh, okay. All right. Oh my god. How did I do this to myself? Oh my god. What the? I lost. I threw. I actually threw. Oh god. No. No. What am I doing, man?
Without a doubt.
Oh shit. Well, since it doesn't matter, I may as well just end. Fuck. Oh no. Okay. Get rid of Catria. I should probably get rid of Bernadetta, if anybody. God, this is so scuffed right now. Oh god, this is so scuffed. You kill Camilla, really? Okay, that doesn't matter right now. Get rid of Catria. Why doesn't he have preempt? What am I doing? Oh my god.
I will go.
How did I do this to myself?
Pressing ever forward. Over here? That's what do you want?
Don't kill me! Okay. We're somehow cooking.
The future is in sight.
You still kill her? Okay, that's really nice.
Speak.
Wait, couldn't Elamine just take her out? Well, I mean, that trap there is... Yeah. Okay, take out Camilla.
Give me an order.
What's that glimmer?
Your life,
so it just does
mine.
30 damage? Wait, what turn is it? Turn 3. I could just lock Mirabilis in place and then it doesn't matter, right?
I won't lose.
Well,
what's your plan?
Let's just come down still. Okay. Somehow, some way, we are living on a prayer. Holy shitballs. This is the real trap. That's, yeah, it's bad. What do I do?
My turn? Sure.
Probably do this? No, because she could warp to Mir- Yeah, let's do this. Get rid of Mirabilis. This would have been so smoother if he had preempt.
Das Bunny.
Okay.
Pressing ever forward.
Yeah, I could just do this. And then, like, reposition her. Yeah. How am I pulling this out of my ass?
Let's see now.
Okay.
I should have lost this.
Give me an order.
Okay. So.
Sure.
I guess.
I won't lose.
Give me an order.
I guess it doesn't really matter,
I'll
but.
This. Give me an order.
Just go there, I guess.
I will go. Over here?
And you have... Okay, I have to completely rework this team. Okay, you come up.
Sure.
Okay.
The future is in sight, speak.
Oh my god, I can't get the pot! Wait!
Pressing ever forward.
I'll handle this.
Okay, no, it's fine. How did I pull this out of my ass? Holy shit. This is like... How does this happen every... It actually didn't happen last... It seems like this only happens on Astra season. Every Astra season, without fail, something somewhere is not correct on a team. What is happening in my life? Oh my god, this was awful. Hold on. Okay, there. Okay, so for one reason or another, whatever it may have been, this team was not locked. I don't know why. But anyways, he's got his preamp back. Man, that was stupid. I can't... Anyways, it worked out in the end. Wow. We'll see you in the next one. Second match. Me groggy. Ugh, god. Luna's ripping up the floor here. Ugh, I got home from work this morning, and I was probably gonna do this then, but, bro, I crashed for like 13 hours. Oh, god. See, this is why I try to do Ether raids at or around reset, because when I sleep and like I'm off, I just sleep, man, like a sloth. Okay, let's see what we got here. God, am I still sleeping? Is this a nightmare? What the fuck is this? Arval is... I just saw Arval. I was like, ugh. Arval, Peony. It's like a nasty combo. Thrasir, Makaya. Change Fate is just still annoying. Oh, excuse me. Okay. So. Okay, look. It's not that bad. It could be worse. There's no save tanks. So, like, we've got that going for us. Actually, is there a Hardy Bearing? There's no Hardy Bearing. Could I just... I'm thinking I might... Could just... Could I just use this? I'm thinking I could just use this. Because most of the enemies here are ranged. Like, all of this are ranged. It's only these two I would have to be wary of. Wait, don't I usually have a far or a near save on this team form? Where'd that go? Hmm. I guess I forewent that for whatever reason. I could also just use Claude, actually. Actually, I don't know. Micaiah would brave attack him. And that would be bad. Could use Fjorm. Although Micaiah would probably brave attack. Yeah, Micaiah would actually brave attack her. Although I got Deflect Magic on her now, but let's not fuck with that possibility. Could also use Dimitri-kun. Dimitri-kun could do quite well here. I actually don't know how his matchup with Thrasir is, though. But, like, it's Dimitri-kun. But, like, yo, preempt is so fun sometimes. Okay. So here's the deal with the deal. I'm just gonna take out Ervil. I'm just gonna run up, kill Ervil, and that'll be the end of it. Why do you have physics still? You're supposed to have nudge. How did I not fix everything? What is happening? What am I doing with my life? Oh my god. Ugh, god, jeez. Okay, I guess depending on whether this is the real trap or not, I could go up and just kill Saros.
Sure.
Okay. Do that.
Give me an order.
Go up, do this. That was the real trap. Good. That means the other one is fake. So I just need to have you out of range of Reason, and it won't matter. Probably just put you here. That don't matter. We've got preempt. Oh. This is gonna heal all of them, but like... This is gonna be bad.
Pressing ever forward.
He's not gonna have his true damage, and all those units are gonna get healed up. But he does have Hexblade, and he has a lot of attack, and all these units have low defense. Hexblade doesn't really matter. Well, it does for Chrom. So maybe it doesn't matter that he's not going to have his true damage. Yo, I can't even get Reason out of here. Bro, what am I doing with my life? Alright, here's what we do.
What's your plan?
Over here?
Well, here's hoping, I guess. If he doesn't one-shot all three of these other units... Okay. Well, it should be fine. Like I said, they all have really low defense. He's not getting his true damage, which was a blunder on my part, but it should be fine. That was almost not fine, because apparently she has DR. What the fuck? Okay. Luckily, it worked out. Yeah, I just need to stay out of the way of that.
Yeah.
Sure. My turn?
Okay! Speak. Without a doubt.
Okay.
Let's see now.
So fortunately, this did work out.
I will go.
Give me an order.
Anyways, yeah, we'll just do that. That was almost really bad. just chalk that up to me not being awake yet. Alright. We'll see you in the next one. Okie dokie, welcome back for this third day. Let's see what we can pull off, shall we? Hopefully no replays. Well rested. I think as I've mentioned before. Or actually, I guess I didn't mention it in the Aether Raids video, I mentioned it somewhere else. But I slept for 13 hours, god damn. Anyways, I'm nice and awake now. And hopefully we can pull something off here. I'm seeing a lot of... Yo, hold on. She doesn't have... Okay, interesting. I'm seeing ranged. Range. Plus a Mirabilis. Interesting. Maybe I just sniped the Legyarn. Or not even Legyarn. Their healing tower is all the way over here. Oh, I guess I would have to kill Legyarn then. So I guess I go up, kill Legyarn. This won't heal anyone. This is all assuming I want to use Yuri here, which I mean, I always want to use Yuri. He's great. What else do I have to work with here? I mean, I don't know if Dimitri... I mean, he probably lives Corrin, but she's probably going to do a lot of damage, too. I'm not super confident in that. Makes things a little awkward for Edelgard, too, so I guess we go preempt Yuri. Screw it. Also, she still has physics for some reason. Hold on, let me fix... Never mind, I just realized I can't fix that because I initiated it. So, whatever, I guess we just deal with it for now. The important thing is, Yuri has preempt. So, maybe I just snipe the healing tower and then get things rolling. Or I could snipe it with somebody else. Hold on. I could actually just snipe it with Elamine. Is there anything... Maybe I false start Sarah. Yeah, maybe I false start the Sarah. So you go there. False start Sarah. We'll see about you shutting off Mirabilis. If I have to go from here, that'd be 1, 2, 3. 5 times 3 is plus 15 to her res, so that gives her 57 to my 56. However, Elamine will give me a buff, so technically, I might be able to stay where I am. I'd put her at 60 res to my 62 with a buff. So it should actually just be fine. We'll see how that goes. If it doesn't work out, whatever. I mean, it's not like Mirabilis will kill Yuri. Let me see. I might just keep Yuri here with, like, Elamine here. Just so that that's dealt with. Actually, I could just go up and snipe that with Regan and she can come right back. I kind of like that idea. So then, Yuri. I guess I repo with Ellawood. I guess I'm gonna have to. Alright. Sure. This should all work out just fine. So.
I won't lose.
You do this. Right?
My turn?
First off, I do this.
Give me an order.
You do that. I could even just bring Yuri down in front of the fortress. That might be a better plan. Yeah, maybe I'll do that. Either way, we are doing this. How does my stylus randomly double tap the screen sometimes? That's gonna get me in trouble one of these days. So, yeah, well, I do like him being here because he can basically just deal with everything. I put you here. This works too, though. But then I... damn it. Maybe I just put you here. Nah. Okay. I guess... Fuck. Thought I had this sorted out. Alright, alright. We'll go with the original plan. Yuri goes here.
Over here?
I'll break that. You come down. You go there. Just so that I don't have to deal with the possibility of Arvel doing shit. I realize that Seether now can't lock out Mirabilis, but I'm just gonna deal with that possibility. I'm just gonna deal with things as they are. Let's go. Oh. Well, that works out. I don't even know if Yuri got Hexblade off. I'm not paying attention to that. Of course, he doesn't have it now, but it won't matter. I just need to...
I'll handle this.
Honestly, get rid of Mirabilis and back off. Yeah, I'm just gonna do that. So, no more dancing for you. I'll go here so Arvel can attack, but Sarah will still be alive. I guess she could just heal Arvel, actually. It probably won't matter, but we'll just do things like this for now.
What's your plan?
Yeah, that's funny.
Let's see now.
The future is in sight. I won't lose. I will go.
So no big deal.
I'll handle this.
Just take out Arvel. Stay where you are. And we can get the pots, so
what's your plan?
Do this.
Without a doubt.
That.
Over here?
I mean, it doesn't matter, just go there. It's fine. Do that.
Okay.
Come up here. So,
that's
can smite. Actually, nah, just...
Give me an order. Sure.
Nah, I'll actually just do this. And we can get a funny kill with Elamine. Great! Good stuff. And that's that. We'll see you for the next day. Day 4. Yo, check it out. I have my upgraded, what's her name? Regan on my teams here. She's not the same on all of them, but, well, I mean, she's mostly the same on all of them. Wait, that's not Regan. Where is she? Yeah, she's, yeah. Anyways, she's built for better support. Now that I've sacrificed some of my Kroms. Alright, let's see what we're dealing with. Hopefully nothing too bad, and it is something too bad. Look, Veronica's here. Along with... Why is Catria here? Not even a Res Catria. Interesting. Okay, so, here's the deal with the deal. This is a fire save for Mortis. We are not afraid of fire save for Mortis. I think I'm just gonna use Edelgard. I think I'm gonna say fuck it, and I'm gonna use Edelgard. Sometimes in life, you just have to say fuck it, you know? Yeah, we're saying fuck it. This is that time in life where you say fuck it.
Succumb to the waves.
Okay, so the plan is to just nudge her up, I think. Yeah. And then Juris can do his thing. Yeah. No, like, guard in play that I can see. We can even just lock Arvel right in place. Great! So, I think what I do is I break this with Seater. Then I can nudge Edelgard up, and then she can start her rampage. Bingo, bango, bongo. What the fuck do I do about Yuri, though? Okay, I think I need to do something a little bit different here. So in order to get Yuri anywheres into anywhere, I don't know. How do I actually do this? Can I even? I don't think I can. I don't know. See, she would need to have, like, repo, but she obviously does not. Damn, how do I do this? Okay, so you need to break that. I nudge you up. So I only have, like, these three to work with, but I can't do that. New plan. New plan. We're gonna smite Edelgard instead. And then you can break this and you can Alright, this is coming together now. It is now coming together. Alright. We can do this. We're living in a world in which we can do this. So. That. Debt.
Without a doubt.
Debt.
Over here?
Debt.
Sure.
We ruin Fomortis's life. Then Edelgard can go on her rampage. Maybe we go on a rampage first. Hold on.
I'll face it head on.
Let's do the rampaging first.
I wish you luck.
I mean, I guess I could just hit and run, but... So, because, like... excuse me. So, what am I going to do here? I'll kill Fremortis with Yuri. Then I'm going to Gale Force off of Veronica. Let's say I kill Krom. No, I actually need to just hit and run. So I'll go up, you go 1, 2, 3. I believe... my thing, all of my goodies should activate. Well, Krom could still come down and attack Yuri, though. Sure. Does that matter? I don't... I might have to just do this and then go behind Edelgard.
I'll face it head on.
Or Edelgard can kill for Mortis. Then Yuri kills Krom, Kanto's in front of Arvel. Use the Gale Force to kill Veronica. And we're... Can Yuri tank both Catria and Mirabilis? Maybe? I don't know. Do I want to do that? I could. Or I could just do the smart thing and play it safe.
Let's swim.
Yeah, let's be boring. Let's just... Look, I'm tired. I got home from work. I just want to go to bed. Because I'm a sleepy boy.
Sure.
Let's just do this. And then we can run away. Oh my god, no we can't. What the fuck?
I'll face it head on.
I think I... screwed myself. I kind of have to do this now. Or, like, I just won't be able to... I guess I just don't attack with Yuri. I mean, that's an option, I guess. That's an unfortunate option, but it is certainly an option. And, unfortunately, I think it's an option I have to take. So, we do this, and that, and you go there. Wait, what? No? Excuse me?
Let's talk about our feelings.
Brother, what happened to my fucking thing? Oh, it got... Dude, fucking catapult. The stupid goddamn dumb bullshit. You never think to look for a fucking catapult, man. Dumb, stupid bullshit. What a joke. Catapult can suck my ass. I just want to go to sleep. I don't want to play this game right now. But this game's not going to let me go to sleep, is it? Because now we've got this cancer to deal with. What the fuck am I even looking at right now? Sorry, I'm irritated. I get irritated and disgruntled when I'm sleepy. Very disgruntled right now. Ugh. What is this garbage? Whatever. You know what? Just whatever.
The wicked will perish.
Whatever. I just don't want to, man. Alright. So, I have to do something like this. I mean, sure. Wait. Damn it. Actually, it doesn't matter. Wait, doesn't it? It doesn't matter. Okay.
Give me an order.
So.
What do you want?
Yeah.
We do this. Does it matter where I put you? I don't think it does. Okay, let me just think about this for a second. I'm gonna go up there with Yuri. Yuri's gonna come down. Doesn't really matter, I guess. Just go there.
Sure.
Okay, yeah, do this. Okay. Yeah, go there.
Okay.
I will go. Yeah. All right, whatever. It's fine. Just do this.
Let's swim.
Get rid of Edelgard.
I wish you luck.
Oh. That's unfortunate. I'm not going to get my my thing. Do I just I think I repo you from here. And then, look, there's no catapult. This should just work.
The future is in sight.
Speak. So, since it should just work,
pressing ever forward, I will go.
Okay, well, that's incredibly unfortunate. Yuri's gonna get gravity. Can't do anything about that.
The future is in sight. I will go.
Let's break this.
Without a doubt. The future is in sight.
Sure. Okay.
I'll handle this.
Oh. Oh, he's above the HP threshold. He didn't get gravity.
Give me an order.
Neat.
Pressing ever
forward.
Okay,
you can kill Shiz.
Without a doubt.
That's, we like that. Bro, how am I gonna get these pots? Why is this always a problem now?
You
have been afflicted with guard, have you not? Wait, have you not? You should have been. Did Arval just not hit you? Or, okay, I have no idea why you didn't. Okay,
let's swim.
Do I want to do this? I think I want to do this. Do I want to do this? Just do it.
I'll study your technique.
Ooh, wow. Arval didn't hit me with guard. Huh? What the heck? How does that work? You know what? Don't question it.
The future is in
Get rid of Shiz.
I won't lose.
Yeah. Okay.
I'll face it.
Get rid
head
of Arval. Gale Force off of him.
I wish you luck.
Okay. I guess.
Let's swim.
Ninian can just bounce off of Edelgard. That's
sure.
Fine.
Speak. I will go.
What do you want?
I will go.
That's funny.
Nope. Oh, she actually has damage now? Interesting. I mean, not that it matters. Wait, what? How did Mirabilis fly in here? That's... Yep.
I'll handle this.
That happened. Get her, Yuri. Alright, well, we pulled that one off. That enemy team was actually scarier than the one I lost to. I don't even... God, I hate losing because of the fucking catapult, man. What a joke. Anyways, that misplay aside, I'm gonna go to sleep. I'll see you guys later.
Alright, we're back. Man,
little bit of an opposite situation today from the last couple of days. I'm still tired because I got back from work this evening. But now I got to switch back to working night shifts. So now I'm in this weird lingo where limbo where I'm like, I should stay awake so that I can sleep during the day. But then I'm really tired. But I know myself, and if I try to take a nap, I'm just going to ignore my alarm and sleep, and then wake up in the morning and be fucked. Yeah. Shift work is rough, guys. You never really get used to it. Anyways. What am I doing? I'm doing this. Aether Raids. Astra. Anima. Let's go. Let's get it. Let's blaze. Yo, speaking of blaze. Honkai Star Rail? The Trailblaze? I'm not gonna lie to you guys, I actually tried that out today. Just to see what all the hype was about. It's kind of fun. And I hate that I like it. Oh, it's so bad. Oh, I can't afford to play another gacha, man. Oh, just be free to play. But free to play is boring. But just do it. But I don't know if I can. Anyways, it's kind of cool. I wouldn't recommend it just because gotchas as a game in general is just I don't recommend to people, but I mean, look, if you're playing Fire Emblem Heroes and you're here watching this video, you're in the rabbit hole, man. You're deep in it. So if you like Genshin Impact, it's a carbon copy of that minus the open world exploration and its turn-based combat. So it's like it's like OG Final Fantasy style combat, but it's like super flashy. It's pretty decent. It's honestly, I hate that I like it. Anyways, what's this? Also, the music is pretty dope. Really good music in that game. All right. Anyways, enough of that shit. What are we dealing with here? What the fuck is this? Why are you Omega Res boosting your Sigurd? So he doesn't get Elamind, I guess? No, that don't matter. I actually don't know what the purpose of that is. Interesting. Tana Banana with a Windsweep. Okay. Arval Lind. Okay. What's the game plan here, Chronicus? What are we gonna do? I see a lot of red stuff. Arval's scary. Also, Tana's got a lot of speed. That's annoying. But could I use Dimitri here? Dimitri-kun could pull this off. I say that, and I see a lot of range units, too. And you know what I say when I see a lot of range units? I just want to use Preempt Yuri, man. That's what it comes down to. What is this? Wait, is this far? That's a near save. Dude, you do not see this. You do not see attack res near save often. That is kind of a rare skill. Interesting. Okay, so Fomortis is their far save. Healing tower there. I do like the set it and forget it method, though. I am a fan of that. Maybe I use Edelgard. Well, Edelgard, stupidly enough, has trouble dealing with herself sometimes. Alright. Let's just! I never use Dimitri, and I put him on Astra for a reason. Let's just. Okay, so. What is the dealio here? Wait, fire and dance. Oh! They're not res boosting Sigurd, they're nuking his attack stat. My guy, just take his weapon off. The fuck? If whatever, you know, teach their own. Hmm. The only problem here is I don't know that Dimitri can outspeed Tana to attack her. But, like, maybe? Not, well, maybe. Maybe. Robin's here. If he gets hit by that, we'll both have unity. Maybe. Maybe and probably. Bro, I live on maybe and probably, okay? That is my ballpark. We just make sure Arvel doesn't go off, I guess. Who do I shut off? Do I shut off anybody? Do I bother doing that? I don't think I could effectively shut anybody off, really. Or, like, that it would matter. Because there's unity in play, I don't think I want to throw Regan around with that snag. But I do need her to give that unity, or that tactic buff to Dimitri. And then that's pretty much the only thing that matters. Oh, man. Okay, well, the sabotage speed is gonna hurt me a bit, but such that it is. I guess I just do this, whatever. Why not? Sure. Okay, so.
Don't be careless.
Oh, okay, that is good, actually. Okay.
Leave it to me.
So, you go here.
There.
Is there a problem?
There.
Why not? I'll do it.
Guess you stay somewhere over here. I don't really need Plumeria to do much of anything, honestly. And we clench and pray. Oh my god. Arvel, don't do it, man. 65 becomes 10. Goddamn. That's what's up. Hey, Lind comes in. Bro, look at these stats. Jesus.
I will protect get her. My people. This battle is over.
Yeah, it is. All right, I am on the Dimitri hype train. He's doing pretty good.
Pressing ever forward.
How do I deal with this apple jackass?
Close your eyes.
Without a doubt.
Over here? Yeah.
Yes.
We'll carve a path.
All right. So with the power of sabotage, Robin now gets this. Good.
The future is in sight.
You almost get that.
Don't be careless.
All right. So we'll give that to Robin.
Ha!
Damn, he almost one shot. Jump on him. All right, good stuff.
Leave it to me.
Why not?
See if Robin can take out Edelgard. Hell yeah, he can.
Ha!
Straight up nuked. God, Robin is such a... He might be the best unit in the entire game right now. So goddamn good. I mean, he could probably deal with Tana, but just to make sure that...
Speak.
You know what? I believe that Robin can take Tana.
Without a doubt.
In Robin, we trust. Let's go. What am I worried about? This unit actually cheats. This unit is the Fae cheat code. Alright. So the reason why they have fire, I now understand this. It's pot denial. I fully understand this now. It is pot denial. What a jerk. But now that I understand what's happening,
over here,
I
will carve a path.
Can plan ahead. Shoot.
I will go.
Hold on. I actually need to just like do that.
Pressing ever forward.
Here.
Close your eyes.
Do this.
I won't lose. Over here?
Did I use Regan's thing already? I think I did. Why'd I even dance Regan? Okay, you come over here. Okay, so now you break that.
I see a way forward.
Yeah.
Do this. You break that.
Don't be careless.
And then we do that. And we're Gucci. Yo, I'm kind of about Dimitri now. That was, yo, we kind of did it. God damn. He kind of just did it, huh? Can't believe it took me this long to hop on the Dimitri train. Yeah, damn. Let's be honest, though. That was basically that. That was like 40% Dimitri, 60% Robin. Let's be honest. Like, if Robin wasn't there, Dimitri would have took so much more damage. He probably would have died. But anyways, that's neither here nor there nor anywheres. And we'll see you for the next battle. Later. Soon, but later. Later, but soon. Hello. Back again for, geez, what is it, Sunday? So next to final day will be another day after today. You may notice some wind in the background. It's quite windy outside. Very gusty. Very gusty. So if there's a little bit of noise, that's what it is. Anyways, moving right along. Yo, I have been lost in Star Rail. I cannot lie to you guys. Oh my god, that game is taking over my life, and I hate that I like that game. Oh! Okay, I already talked about this yesterday, but man, I like played Star Rail like all goddamn night. Why do I like it? It's like the game is like, it's like it's a shiny pebble and I'm an idiot crow. And I see something shiny and I'm like, caca! I don't want to like it, but it's fun. Anyways, here we are. God damn it. It's perfect, man, because the new character, John Yang, I believe his name is, I just call him Adult Kazuha, aka Susanoo. I mean, if you play Genshin Impact, the dude just looks like a 40-year-old Kazuha, so I just call him Adult Kazuha. But because of how his abilities work, I also refer to him as Susanoo. And it's just so badass. That is such my aesthetic when it comes to characters. I love it so much. And, ugh. They got me, man. They just got me right now. Oh, anyways. So that's what I've been doing the last, like, night and a half, basically. Just kind of getting into that game a little bit. And honest to God, it is pretty fun. But that's neither here nor there nor anywhere. Let's get back into this bull-ish. Got a kind of a defense we got here, like warping defenses. With Carla here. Maybe I should put my Carla on in my defense, because my anima defense is still performing quite poorly. So, I'm not sure how to make it better. I'm really not sure how to upgrade my anima game. I went 3 losses in a row so far. Pretty bad. Had a strong start, but like my team is very susceptible to strong Omni tanks, right? So it's not... I just don't know how to... My dark defense performs very well, but my anima defense... I don't know what the difference is. I just can't make a good anima defense to save my life. But, anyways, we are here to do this. So, I don't know that I want to put Dimitri up versus Carla. So I'm not going to do that. Probably just use Edelgard, actually. Edelgard can walk up here onto this, and although Niffle's DR, she could probably just survive. Well, no, Edelgard will actually quad attack her. No, because she has NFU, right? So that negates her, yeah. So she'll only just brave attack, like normal brave attack. But I do like Edelgard here. I mean, either that, or what I could do, there's no hardy bearing in play. I could actually just come up here, snipe. Well, no. Fomortis would be the one to go down, but that's fine, because it's not like Carla could, like, yeah, because you won't be able to dance her from that, where you are, so it should be okay. Do I have a dancer on the team? I don't think I do. It shouldn't really matter. I could also just lock down Mirabilis with Seether and not worry about that. Or I could even just lock down Carla and she can waste her dance on Carla. That's fine too. So preempt Yuri is surprisingly an option here, just even though, like, despite there being mostly melee units, actually. There's only two range units for him to preempt. Now, if I went with the hit and run Edelgard, what would be the plan? More or less the same. Come up, snipe the Fomortis, and then, so I have to smite Edelgard up, and she can start doing her thing, I suppose. Go in on Niffle, maybe even Edelgard, and then back off. Well, I don't like that. I have to hit once, then back off and reposition, actually, because of Lind and such. I don't hate the idea of using Yuri here, though, just because the units that he would preempt would be nice to get off the board, like, right away. Otherwise, it can cause some annoying things to happen. But I'll give Edelgard a go. This should be fine, because Yuri can still take out Fomortis. The healing tower's all the way over here, so all these guys will still, like, be underneath, will be at 1 HP pretty much, and then all their weapons will more or less not be active, right? Do they all have a quarter HP stipulation? If you initiate combat, this one is a proxy. Initiation on proxy. This one is proxy. Damn, okay. How does your weapon work? Odd numbered turns, that's the cooldown. The initiation proxy, okay, so none of them, HP doesn't really matter for any of them then, huh? Damn, that's annoying. Oh well. So, this should work. There's no counter control. I'm pretty sure I would have subconsciously saw that. So I need you to attack from like here.
I will go.
Attack from there and come on like over here, I guess.
Give me an order.
You do that. Okay, so the trap next to Yuri is real. Wait, what? Oh. That's fine. She won't kill Yuri. I'm not too worried about that.
I won't lose.
I mean, his solo's already not active, but... yeah, I'm not too worried about it.
What do you want?
Whoa! Good, you do take out Niffle. So we'll do that.
I'll study your technique.
Oh, you just take her out in one hit, goddamn. I guess I could actually just take out Lind and Tana right here, and then it's not like Carla would do any damage to me. Should be fine. You know what? I'm just gonna do it.
Let's swim.
I'm not afraid of you. Let's go.
I wish you luck. I'll face it head on. I'll study your technique.
Should be GG's. Carla should just bump right off of Edelgard. Oh, wait, I'm not gonna get... okay, good. I was gonna say, Fallen Edelgard's actually gonna have her two movement. Oh my god, that did so much oh, wait, am I dead here?
I detest...
Brother! No shot! In what fuck... okay, whatever. Fuck you. Come on. Fucking idiot. Dude, Fallen Edel, bitch, of all goddamn fucking things. Come the fuck on with that shit. Oh my god, what a joke. This dog shit right here, this is why I'm escaping to other games. Fucking dumb bullshit. Well, at least here I've got like a boxing situation that makes it fairly simple. They don't even have a healing tower. That's nice. Whatever. I'll go with this. I don't care. Fuck this game. I guess it doesn't really matter. Actually, no. Put you there. Do something like this. Do that. Go there. Do this. I guess it doesn't really matter where you go. Go over there, I suppose.
Sure.
Here, do that. I had to go and underestimate Carla.
Okay! Without a doubt.
What do I even do with you?
Pressing ever forward.
Doesn't really matter, I guess.
My turn?
Put you there, I suppose. Oh my god. That was almost really bad. He would have killed me with that sublime heaven.
Give me an order.
Anyways, take out the heroes.
Let's see now.
The future is in sight.
What's your plan?
Without a doubt. Speak. Das Bunny!
Yeah!
Okay!
Oh. No, whatever, I guess.
Won't lose.
Didn't really matter.
What do you want?
Doesn't really matter.
Shh.
Pressing ever forward.
I
will go. Over here? Dust Bunny! The future is in sight.
I'll handle this.
Yeah, whatever, I guess. Just get that.
Speak. I won't lose. Okay! Yeah!
Oh. That's slightly annoying.
Give me an order.
Whatever. Wait, what? Oh, right. I'm so dumb!
Without a doubt.
My turn?
The future is in sight.
Whatever. Come on.
I will go. Pressing ever
forward. What's
your
plan?
The future is
there
in
go.
Sight.
You do something. Ooh.
Speak. I won't lose.
Sure.
What do you want?
Over here? I won't lose.
I am almost out of turns.
I will go. Speak.
Give me an order.
Guess I can do this. This doesn't really matter, I guess. Alright, sure, why not? There you go. We did it! Yeah. We did it! Yeah! Oh, wow! I can't believe it, man. Friggin' Edelgard. Fallen Edelgard! Of all things, to bring me to my knees! I hate it! Damn it! Well, whatever. See you for the final day momentarily.
Okay, here we are to finish things up. Hopefully, it's not too bad. But, bad things can happen. This doesn't look atrocious. It could be worse. That's a farce. Alrighty. This could be worse. where can the Sonya get to? She's gonna have a Luna ready to go. But I think I'd rather her have Luna charged up than like Katria's bullshit go off. However. Well, Asker is annoying, but I don't know if I could preempt Asker successfully. It would be worth trying, though. What about Claude? How does Claude fare against this stuff? Excuse me. How does Claude fare against this stuff? Maybe okay. Won't be able to do anything to Fomortis. That'll have to be somebody else. Probably Robin. What about this team? How does Fjorm fare? Well, Fjorm doesn't do super well versus Volk. I mean, maybe I could just use this team. This should be okay. Oh my goodness. My sinuses are just acting up lately. Okay, so, do that, but then I need that,
But then. Jeez. Okay. Alright. So we do that. Oh. Well. Okay, nothing's gonna break my safe defense. I remembered. We're looking for catapults from now on. It's right here. It's not gonna break my fence. Okay, so she got false started. I think I just leave you where you are. We do that. Stay there. You come here. Okay. You go there. Go up and do that. Now.
I won't lose.
How do you fare versus Asker? We are gonna find out.
I'll face it head on.
You fare well. This is good. Now Asker does have guard in his weapon, so I should attack Asker before I attack with Yuri.
Let's swim.
So that I shall do. Action. It might not matter, because I can't go up and attack something else after the fact, so... But it would be nice to charge up the Gale Force anyway, so...
I'll face it head on.
I guess I'll do that.
I wish you luck.
Now, that was the fake one. So wherever the other one is, that's the real. So this is the real one. So... You could just kill for mortars, but sure. I'm gonna just do this. And then we'll run away. I've been burned before by trying to leave Edelgard in the path of things that I thought would do nothing to her, but then they just end up doing stuff to her. And how come Edelgard didn't get any charges on her Gale Force? What the fuck?
Let's swim.
No shot she didn't have more attack than Asker. That is dumb.
Well, I'll face it.
Whatever,
on.
I guess. Whatever. Okay.
Give me an order.
Now.
Without a doubt. Yeah.
I think I do this. I can go over here.
Sure.
So I think I want to get rid of Catria. Can do this. Actually, let's get you up there.
Let's swim.
And let's actually do this instead. We'll do this.
I'll study your technique.
What do you have, Moonbow? Okay, so now I'm gonna take out. Okay, you have tempo.
I'll face it head on.
Which is bad, so damn, I'm not gonna. Is that only if you initiate? If unit initiates combat or is not adjacent to an ally, unit neutralizes effects that inflict special cooldown charge minus X. Oh, it's only for himself, so you should get your Gale Force.
I wish it should be fine.
Yeah. So now, I wanna take out Sonya.
Technique.
Get rid of that. Okay.
Pressing ever forward.
I'll handle this.
Then probably get rid of Mira. And then Thrasir can just attack Edelgard and it'll be fine.
Give me an order.
So yeah, we'll do that. So, you can come down here. You can go there. Actually, wait, what turn is it? Turn two.
The future is in sight.
Dressier won't work. I could do this to double up on your res. Do that.
Without a doubt.
There you go. That's fine. That'll only do 6 damage. No bigs. And now we get that. And we are good. Must have gotten the other pot earlier. I don't recall. But anyways. Good. Wasn't too bad. One match to go. The final opponent for this week shall be Altina. Oh god, what is this? Am I afraid of this? Yo, that's a plus 10 shiz. Am I afraid of this? Okay, that's hardy bearing. Is that sound? Yeah, my cats are banging on something upstairs. I'm gonna have to check on that soon. Is there Kanto control? Okay, Robin's got Kanto control. However, if I initiate from right here, it doesn't activate, and they're kind of just boxed in. Interesting. Very interesting. Okay. I might try the preempt Yuri here. Fortunate that Shez will get healed up, but I think this will be fun. I think we can pull something off with this. I see what they're trying to do. They're trying to just snipe someone with Tana. I think she's got that white cap bow. She actually would probably kill Yuri because of hardy bearing. Well, I don't know if she has the speed stat to brave attack me, though. Probably not. Even with Unity, I have double buffs. It's not like she has a lull or anything. Should maybe be fine? But I don't know. And just lock out their peony on the first turn, so I don't have to worry about dancing shenanigans. I guess I can just make sure they don't get their Robin stuff going on. And I mean, I guess this is fine.
I'll handle this.
Go up, take out the Fomortis. Here, I guess.
I will go.
Bring you there. I'm gonna keep you here. I don't need the pots, so let's maybe just.
What do you want?
Bring you guys over here slowly. Okay. Now. What exactly do I do from here?
Give me an order.
Maybe I just break this and get rid of their Tana next turn. Or I could probably do it now. Just do a double repo shenanigan. Then their warping abilities are pretty much gone. So just like do this. Do this. Stay there. Do that. Come over here.
I'll handle this.
I actually can't do that. Hold on.
Sure.
I have to like do this and then put you here. And then smite him onto that trap, because I almost did the same thing as with the match the other day. Subconsciously assumed he had disarm trap. That's the problem when I use these two different Yuri builds the most often throughout the week, I forget that he doesn't have something that the other Yuri has. Anyways. So just bring you down, bring you over. Oh my god. Well, that just did not work. Oh my fucking Jesus. Oh my god, I just got absolutely decimated. Well, that sucks. Yeah. Well, such that it is, I suppose. I guess I should have just put Yuri in range of Tana anyways, I guess, because, yeah, after I initiated in Fomortis, that's actually a solid defense. I might copy that, actually, for my own anima defenses, because my anima defense is really bad. It's super, super inconsistent. It's like half failures, half successes. That was... Aw, damn, I should... It's not like I can even remember what it was now, but... whatever. Doesn't matter. Anyways. This is what the fence is for. What do we have here? You know what this is? This is a Dimitri. This is a Dimitri clear, through and through.
The future is in sight.
Let's get it done.
We will not falter.
Nah, you just go here. Yeah, you just go there.
Yeah.
And then I guess crap baskets. I'm not sure where the enemy's gonna end up.
I'll do it.
Oh no, I might have screwed up. Right here because of this. Okay. Here's what we do.
I will go.
We nudge. We nudge and we pray.
We'll carve a path.
We nudge, pray.
Over here? Pressing ever forward.
Oh good. Yeah, okay. Well, their dancer's gone anyways. So that's fine. Should heal most of this off. Oh, that only did 11 damage.
This battle is
Yo,
over.
Dimitri's Well, I mean, I proved it to myself last time. Dimitri's just kind of good. She's not going to brave attack me, I hope. I actually should have looked at her weapon to remind myself how it worked. Okay, it's fine.
Out of the way.
I'm pretty sure she has this like a similar brave stipulation where she has to meet like a plus 10 speed check or something like that. I don't actually remember, but Dimitri no longer has all of his buffs, so I'm gonna come all the way down.
I won't lose. Close your eyes. Why not?
Yeah.
I see a way forward. We'll carve a path.
Yeah, I'm just gonna do something like this, I guess.
I'll do it.
Over here? Without a doubt. Yeah.
Oh, God. Dude, this asker. Yeah, Dimitri doesn't have his NFU. Oh, this is bad.
A new year.
This might do a ton of damage. Okay, not that much damage. What the fuck happened there? How the hell did Duma even reach me? What? I have no idea what just happened there. What the fuck? Hello? Oh, Wings of Mercy. That's what happened. Oh my god, that almost sucked.
Close your eyes.
Yo, Fluria can get that? That's kind of hilarious.
The future is in sight. I won't lose.
Might do this and back off. Yeah.
Over here?
I'm gonna just do this. Just make sure there's no, like, canto control.
I won't lose. This is it for you.
Get him. So, fortunately, we don't need any of the pots.
Is there a problem? We'll carve a path.
Probably just do this. What's your build? Catch? That's no big deal. Well, lunge, but it shouldn't matter. Should be fine.
Pressing ever forward.
Actually, I could also just dance seat there and shut off Sigurd, and that would take up Plumeria's dance. So that's
I will go.
Something I can do, I guess.
We will not falter. Don't be careless.
Why not? I'll do it.
I don't want to dance from it, because I could reposition up and just kill Sigurd myself.
Close your eyes.
That could
the
work.
The future is in sight.
We will not falter.
No reason that doesn't work, right?
Without a doubt.
Don't be careless.
Should be fine.
I see a way forward.
Okay. Dimitri did it! And we don't need the pots. Good stuff. Alright, so that's an Astro Week. I had one or two pretty bad days just because I was overly sleepy with it, but it worked out in the end. No big deal. Might try and activate every particle of my lizard brain to see if I can remember that defense that I'd lost to just now, because that was kind of big brain. It didn't look that bad, but it was actually really good. Because I seriously need to update my anima defense. It's super inconsistent. My dark defense is pretty solid, but yeah, my anima needs a lot of work. Anyways, hope you enjoyed the Astro Week runs, and if you did, consider liking and subscribing, and we'll check in some more videos. Peace out. We gotta let it get back. Fight the fucking best of you know you had to kill her.